Ang Pasko ay maliit na liwanag lamang. Ang totoong liwanag ay si Kristong muling nabuhay. Kung hangang-hanga na tayo sa Pasko, sabi ng Panginoon ngayong Pasko, "You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come." Naramdaman na po ba ninyong maharap sa dead end? Yung nagkamali ka ng pasok sa daan at pagkatapos, wala ka nang pwedeng puntahan. Kapag ganon na napaharap tayo sa dead end, iisa lang ang makatwirang gawin. Mag-U-turn. Kung ikay naglalakad, about face. Kung ayaw mo mag-about face, atras at humanap ng ibang daan. 2,000 years ago, humanity faced a dead end. And God saw it. God saw it in three important men to whom Christmas was first proclaimed. Na dead end sila. Ang unang dead end people ay yung mga pastol. Can you imagine? It was already night and they were still working. Kailan sila magpapahinga? Nagtatrabaho tayo sa araw. Pero hating gabi, nagtatrabaho pa rin. It must be so boring. It must be so monotonous. They were practically working for 24 hours. They knew boredom. They knew dryness. They knew burnout because of work. Ang pangalawa na dead end ay yung mga wise men. They were not actually kings. They were astrologers. They were scientists. They were philosophers. They were looking at the behavior of the stars and the planets. They were searching for wisdom. And then, being philosophers, being men of wisdom, they were already meeting a dead end. When philosophy meets emptiness, when research meets emptiness, and you don't know where to proceed anymore because you do not know how to explain anymore. And the last man was Simeon. We will encounter him on Sunday. He was not in Bethlehem, but he was in the temple, representing religion. Religion that is full of rituals. Religion that has become dry because the rituals have only become pageantry. Pagandahan na lang, palakasan na lang ng ilaw, palabuan na lang ng usok ng insenso, and life was already getting monotonous in the temple. So there were the shepherds, bored from work. There were the philosophers, facing emptiness with human wisdom. And there was Simeon, who was already old and then facing the monotony of meaningless religious pageantry. And God saw the dead end and pierced it, made a little hole so that light can shine. And when God pierced the dead end, the shepherds became excited. Simeon in his old age became excited. And the wise men saw another discovery that they will carry for the rest of their lives with much wonder, awe, and excitement. That little piercing of the dead end created a lot of hope from the boring religious rituals, from the emptiness of philosophy, and from the monotony of work, ordinary work. But you see, my dear brothers and sisters, hindi po nagtapos doon Ang dami ngayong tao dito sa katedral kasi Pasko. Pero tandaan natin na ang Pasko ay hindi ang pinakamahalagang piyesta ng Kristiyano. Sapagkat yung Pasko ay maliit na butas lamang dun sa dead end. At lumaki yung butas. Saan tayo dinala? Dinala tayo dun sa krus. Pero hindi natapos sa krus. Dinala tayo sa muling pagkabuhay. At ang tanda ng muling pagkabuhay ay hindi si Kristo sa sabsaban, hindi si Kristo sa krus, kundi si Kristo sa tabernakulo, sa Santissimo Sacramento, sa Eucharistia. This is Easter, and we will not be able to appreciate Christmas without Christ risen from the dead. Pero, tingnan pa rin natin, kanino unang ipinahayag ang pagkabuhay ng Panginoon? Tatlong klase pa rin ng tao. Tatlong klase ng taong naka-dead end. To whom did He reveal? To fishermen. To fishermen who had been tired of fishing all night and catching nothing. The Lord revealed Himself as the risen Christ, winner over death, to fishermen who were so tired, who were so bored, who were so hopeless and desperate because they have been fishing all night, catching nothing. To whom did He appear? He appeared to Thomas after 8 days. Thomas was the representative of the philosopher who said to see is to believe. Thomas is the representative of the scientist. Unless I touch the wounds, I will not believe. Thomas was facing emptiness because he knew by science that dead men do not rise from the tomb. And among religious leaders, to whom did the Lord appear? The Lord appeared to Saul, a die-hard Pharisee, a die-hard expert of the law. He was already facing the law, he had memorized the law, but he was also facing emptiness because it was becoming clearer and clearer. The more he obeyed the law, the more he got convinced that the law would not save him. And then he asked, who will save me? Thomas asked, how will I explain this? And the fisherman said, we are tired fishing all night and catching nothing. My dear brothers and sisters, you cannot understand Christmas separated from Easter. And both Easter and Christmas were occasions of humanity at a dead end. Wala na talagang pupuntahan. Walang mahuli, buong magdamag, nagtatrabaho kahit magdamag. Wala na talagang mapuntahan. Nakita na lahat ng bituin, pero walang maipaliwanag. Wala na talagang mapuntahan kasi hindi niya mahawakan ang sugat ng kanyang maestro. And he could not believe that people rise from the dead. Wala na talagang pupuntahan. Matanda na si Simeon at si Pablo, sawang-sawa na sa matas na hindi makapagligtas. My dear brothers and sisters, God knows how it is to face a dead end. If you are facing a dead end in your life, ask the Lord, Lord, you pierced the dead end 2,000 years ago. Pierce my dead end now and give me a little hope. Give me a little light. Dead end na ba sa atin ang coronavirus? Dead end na ba sa atin ang extrajudicial killings? Dead end na ba sa atin ang drugs? Dead end na ba sa atin ang problema ng mundo? Dead end na ba ang giyera sa Syria at Egypt at Nigeria? My dear brothers and sisters, with God, there are no dead ends. With God, you do not even have to make a U-turn. With God, you do not even have to turn to the left or to the right when you face a blank wall. Because if you ask God for help, He will destroy that wall. He will pierce that dead end. And He's going to lead you to His cross. And He's going to lead you from the manger to the empty tomb. Simula 2,000 years ago hanggang ngayon, ang dami-dami ng dead end na hinarap ng sangkatauhan. At marami sa sangkatauhan nagsikap na lampasan ang dead end. Subalit, kung hindi tayo hihingi ng awa sa Diyos, ang dead end ay mananatiling dead. Sa awa at tulong ng Diyos, mabubutas ang dead end. At sa awa at buti ng Diyos, ang dead end ay magiging eternal road, endless road, a door that is endlessly open to life everlasting. Ang Pasko ay maliit na liwanag lamang. Ang totoong liwanag ay si Kristong muling nabuhay. Kung hangang-hanga na tayo sa Pasko, sabi ng Panginoon ngayong Pasko, "You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come. Wait until I'm 33. Wait until they kill me. Wait until they bury me. And then after they bury me, I will show you the real cause of joy. I will rise from the dead. And there will be no more dead ends. There will be no more closed walls. There will be no more closed doors. Because the doors of heaven will be perpetually open. Because the one who is born is risen from the dead."